Ah, Detroit. I was born and raised for most of my life in this great city. I mean, there's so much to experience in this place. The sports, you got the arts, the food, the culture, and the community. When I was a kid, my family was set up on the east side. And the Lord really blessed my family so that both my parents were in the home while my siblings and I grew up. I got a taste of both the urban life as well as the suburban life. My family moved a few blocks across 8 Mile to little old East Point. Now there's a considerable difference between the two cities, but I love living in both. From first grade to ninth grade, I was able to attend a new up-and-coming charter school by the name of Detroit Academy of Arts and Sciences. Upon the second semester of my ninth grade year, my parents and I came to the acceptance that this school had lost its focus and it was time to change my educational experience. In 2006, I was fortunate to be able to enroll into Cass Tech High School, where I would finish my high school education in a commercial art curriculum. Cass Tech supplied me with an awesome high school adventure, which ultimately led me to want to matriculate at the College for Creative Studies. While pursuing my Bachelor's of Fine Arts, I decided to couple my entertainment arts interest with the art education program and was later given an internship opportunity with Community Arts Partnerships. I decided to make this documentary because growing up, I was never made aware of any outside of school activities that involved digital art in Detroit. But outside of Detroit, it was a necessity. So therefore, I feel I was not adequately prepared for the digital side of CCS when I entered. And this led me to question, are digital skills really necessary? And to begin my quest, I will start by finding out if other CCS students feel the same way.
I am from Miami, Florida, and I went to New World School of the Arts.
I'm from Brooklyn, New York, and I went to high school, Thomas Edison High School in Jamaica.
And I went to University of Detroit Jesuit High School.
I went to Wild Lake Northern High School.
I'm from Troy. I went to Troy High.
And I went to Catholic Central High School.
I went to Stony Creek High School in Rochester Hills, Michigan.
And I went to Dakota High School in Macomb.
I graduated from Fortson High School.
I grew up in Westlake, Michigan. I went to John Glenn High School.
I'm from Detroit, Michigan, and I went to Cass Technical High School.
Went to Detroit Technology High School.
The old high school I went to was St. Mary's Preparatory in Orchard Lake, and I'm from Metamora, Michigan.
I grew up in Caledonia, Michigan, and I went to Caledonia High School.
I went to Stony Creek High School, and I'm from Rochester, Michigan.
Do you feel that you are prepared for this curriculum?
In some ways, I was prepared for the digital curriculum.
No, not at all, actually.
I think I was.
Not at all.
No, I did not.
Hey, I mean, there were some learning curves, but
not as much as I needed to be.
I mean, I knew my way around Mac computers, but I knew nothing about Photoshop when I came here.
No, I was not.
I was kind of half and half. It was dependent on the program.
I had a decent understanding.
Kind of, sort of, not really.
Not quite.
No, actually, I don't.
No, I do not feel that I was prepared whatsoever.
As you saw, I received mixed responses. So I turned to the department chairs to get their thoughts on digital learning.
They play an important role in what we do, especially as a tool for creativity. Ideas don't come from computers and digital, but they're part of a tool to create our work.
The role of digital skills in the department is to be able to express the ultimate goal of the interior designer, to be able to present to a client what the space feels like and what is it going to be like.
Digital skills play a couple of different roles. The first one is in 2D image development. So at the early part of the program, I think it's best to have them work with the simple tools like pencils and paper.
In the product design department, the role of digital skills is crucial. Of course, we work on great ideas, but then we should be able to communicate our ideas. Our program is focused to help the student starting from scratch.
Digital skills and illustration, it's kind of seamless in many ways. I see it as a tool and a medium. As long as you're comfortable in the analog world, I think you can go back and forth between digital media and traditional media and not really have too much problem. We work with the Foundations Department. The Foundations Department offers digital fundamentals. We essentially are following their lead, and you know, our students are expected to take that class as are many other majors at the college.
In my department, we just start the process by introducing digital skills in digital fundamentals. That introduces the students to the Adobe suite of digital skills, Photoshop, Illustrator, a little web design, digital organization.
It varies. For a freshman coming into entertainment arts, I would like them to have an understanding of digital technology, but it's not a requirement.
Well, we don't. Students come from a variety of different backgrounds and experiences, and certainly high schools vary widely in terms of skill level.
Sometimes it can be uneven. It really varies. Every class is different. Even though you've taught the class many times before.
High schools vary so drastically today that it's hard to insist on a certain level of skill, I think.
We have structured our program so that we have no technical expectations of that type on a student coming in. We'll teach them whatever we feel that they need to learn.
We'll have students come in with a really broad range of digital skills, and we'll have students come in with very little. So we're perfectly happy with that. So it isn't necessary that somebody comes in as some kind of tech genius.
If they come to CCS or any other institution, any other college with a higher level knowledge, of course they start in an advantage position.
It's really important that they have some comfort level with a computer and with some of the programs that are out there. It would be very helpful for that to happen, although it doesn't always happen.
So we'll take care of all that if they don't have it. And sometimes their digital skills are not correct, and we have to refine them. Some schools have great art teachers. Some schools have great technology teachers. Some schools have great resources, and frankly, others don't.
I think it's sometimes maybe the resources in the home, sometimes it's the resources in the school, and sometimes it's the priorities in the school.
The knowledge varies because they come from different areas.
You can't really manage what happens before they get here. You can only react to them once they're here.
I think it has to do with money.
There is a cost involved with this, and I think that's one of the things that restricts a lot of the high schools from really going into it and offering these kinds of things to their students.
Wealthy schools, students come prepared with a lot more digital skills than students that come from poorer urban areas or poorer rural areas.
I don't think that students are necessarily being, say, encouraged to work with software and digital tools that help them on the creative side.
Digital skills play an important role in all of the departments, but all the programs are geared to develop a student's basic traditional skills first, then digital learning is implemented. To add more weight to my investigation, I branched out to CAP faculty and a few educators in Oakland County to get a view on this topic from the pre-college side.
Work with artists, we train artists to go out into the community and work with schools, rec centers, park district facilities, places like that, to do long-term art education programs.
Digital skills are really important because part of what we're doing with this particular curriculum is preparing students for real-world experiences.
With everything being so digitized,
digital skills are pretty much the fundamentals of this coming generation.
So this is all about documenting and finding ways to explore their creativity.
Yeah, I mean, most of the kids we have, I mean, it's 2013, you know what I mean? They come in with their cell phones, their iPods, they can fix things digitally quicker than we can.
If you've got great ideas, original ideas, that's what matters. That's the value for the digital tools going forward, is that young people that are able to be exposed to them at a young age are going to be able to create in ways that our generation never has.
The challenge is we don't have computers for every student.
If the program is run well, then we're able to do our job really well, but if it's not, well then we struggle a little bit harder, but we're still, you know, still trying for the same goal.
It's unfortunate that times have gotten so rough in the Midwest that schools are being forced to choose one program over another for expenditures in digital.
And our focus here is trying to get students to learn how to make things, you know, and how to think, you know, and how to really develop a process, you know, for making art.
We feel that it's very important here at Lake Orion High School to offer computer art to our students. And we don't just do it as like an add-on. It's really ingrained in our curriculum.
The digital world plays a big role in my classroom. I teach drawing and painting, so I mean they aren't necessarily using technology to make art necessarily, but they certainly use it to do research.
We are given the freedom to teach with the tool that works the best for us. So if that means pencil and paper, use pencil and paper. If that means going straight to digital, go straight to digital.
I believe that there should be technology in the curriculum no matter what. It is something that needs to be funded.
As a teacher, I feel like as long as you are effective in teaching your students, you should be as autonomous as you possibly can be.
I prepare students to go out and teach in the K-12 environment, and so our students have to be adept and aware of technology.
I think that the digital skills can be a great way, the same way that painting or drawing can be, for students to kind of explore their own ideas, explore the ideas of others.
Well, children are children, and I think that one of the things we find is that kids can learn and adapt very easily. They are basically little sponges many times. So it's so unfortunate that the urban districts don't have the money, don't have the facilities, and can't afford to either buy the equipment or maintain it.
There's a real challenge in doing things like digital graphic arts or digital animation, something like that, when you don't have high quality computers and you don't have access to kind of controlled digital studios.
It's just a shame, and I think we need to figure out how to help the urban districts find monies to bring their classrooms up to date.
So I think it has the potential to really create a lot of benefit. But again, the issue for us is just access to the hardware and the software.
The director of the Pre-College and Continuing Studies program at CCS offered input as well to help with my investigation.
We do try to regularly offer courses that incorporate digital skills so that the students get an opportunity to at least get an introduction to what some of those tools are, what some of the software is that they might be using if they were to come here to CCS or any other College of Art and Design. We've been recently offering courses for art educators specifically, and we do have some digital tools built into a few of those workshops because we want the educators to understand how to use the new technology. We have fewer adults from Detroit proper than we do from the suburbs. The same is somewhat true of the pre-college and youth programs. If you're not at least familiar and comfortable with trying out new technology, understanding what it can do and how it might help you, I think you're going to end up a little behind. If you have one group with something and another group that doesn't have access to that something, then you're just going to consistently perpetuate the issue of not having access or developing the skill. A couple of other school districts have this iPad per student program, and that's something that the district as a whole has made a decision to invest in. So every student in every classroom has access to an iPad to use for their work, whether it be in English, math, science, or art. And I think that a program like that in Detroit would be fantastic because it would allow equal access to all of the students in the system and to the teachers in the system.
Digital skills play an important role in our society and culture. So they should play an important role in education. Are digital skills necessary? I would say yes. Students should be aware to learn the digital knowledge, and educators should be aware to teach the digital knowledge.
It is an awesome resource that is limited by the person, not by the technology.
Becoming completely dependent and neglecting a firm understanding of traditional learning styles and traditional skills.
I'm afraid a lot of people are missing out on the quality of what digital tools can do because they just use it straight out of the box. It's like trying to do detail work with a spray can.
It can be an inhibitor in that people think it's a kind of an easy path.
It's never going to replace just good old-fashioned concepting. You know?
Not looking within for images. We're looking on the screen for images that have already been prefabricated.
Computers are not where ideas come from.
The most important thing that you can have is to have good ideas. So to have good ideas, you don't need the tools.
In order to have a successful outcome, you need the analog process to be able to finalize your input in the digital process.
If you're thinking about endless limits, then it's best to start the ideation process before you get to the digital.
So, what have I learned from all of this? Digital skills are really undervalued in the educational system of Detroit, but they can help aid traditional skills, not replace them. I had one more question I thought I'd ask before I wrap this up.
That's a difficult question.
It's coming our way, so we can't ignore it. And, you know, we'll be the albatross in the classroom if we do.
It really should start early.
I don't think you can start them too early.
I think that it should be started from an early age.
If we don't teach kids from an early age, we're going to start to fall behind the country.
I believe the digital world in the elementary level should be exploration.
They should be introduced to digital learning. Because it is the 21st century reality.
Kids aren't waiting till they get to school to learn this stuff. Why should we slow them back?
They're developing children. So, you know, them developing their tactile skills is important.
I don't know where I stand on that one, because I think it should probably be slowly incorporated.
If you introduce digital technology, introduce this into the classroom at that stage, you have to build bridges between traditional pedagogy.
I do really think it's important for us to be able to incorporate it in the right ways and know when to use it and when not to use it.
There should be some experiences, but like I said before, you know, it's in moderation.
Is it appropriate to use digital, or is it appropriate just some days to go back to pencil and paper?
If you don't have that well balanced, it's not right.
You can't go 100% one way or the other.
And I think the classroom is a great opportunity for us to teach these young students' self-regulation.
There's math, reading, language. All those things can be enhanced by utilizing digital learning platforms.
I feel like it is definitely more of a necessity now than it was before.
I think it should play a larger role than it does today.
I think there's a good way to use it and a bad way to use it, obviously.
You need to learn how to understand how to draw and paint directly, you know, so that when you get to the technology, when you get to the drawing tablet or, you know, whatever digital technology you're using, you know what you're doing.
This question received mixed responses, and I noticed that the real battle is traditional versus digital. I was able to answer my questions from the beginning of this documentary, but the new emerging questions I have are, what is the balance between traditional and digital? And how do you measure if students are being equipped with this balance?
Getting back, but you knew I would. War is hell. When will it end? When will people start getting together again? Are things really getting better?